Hey guys, welcome to Whiteboard Wednesday. I'm Irfan Baqui, and in this series, I solve coding problems on a whiteboard in a real interview setting. And the problems are chosen by my wife, who's also a software engineer, and she acts as an interviewer. As I solve the problems on the whiteboard, you will see how I interact with her and also how I approach those problems. And this time, she has chosen a Google interview question. So let's see where it is.
Okay. So here's this week's question. How would you implement a queue using stacks?
So I've actually encountered this problem before. So if you don't mind, I'll set it up over here and we'll go through it.
Yeah, sure.
So let's say in this case, let's say I have an input of random integers that they're coming in and I want to mimic a queue using two stacks, right?
Okay.
So let's say inputs are just integer. Let's say it's an integer stream, which is basically pushing of integers. Mm-hmm. And output should be a queue with stacks. And let's say the input may actually even be a stack, you know, stack, and then the input to the stacks will be the integers.
Okay.
So the way I would do this is I'll have one stack as an onQueue stack. Mm-hmm. And another stack as a dequeue stack.
Okay.
So in this case, any time, let's say this is the input stream, I for inputs. And I'm inputting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Mm-hmm. Let's say in a row, no DQ yet. So it'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7.
So it's basically you are just pushing to the NQ stack.
I'm just pushing to the onQ stack. Now, the moment there is let's say D is for DQ. Mm-hmm. The moment there is a DQ command, then I will need to reverse this entire thing. Mm-hmm. So that's when the DQ stack comes in. So basically, I will see, hey, is there anything in the DQ stack? If there is, then you output that. That would be the result of the D. But if there isn't, then you pop everything out from here and you push it into DQ. So basically, as you pop these out, you'll have 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. So you have to pop all of them out. So for each DQ command, basically you need to empty the onQueue stack.
Okay.
So now you will see that this is like when we're DQing, this mimics a queue. So using these two stacks, you know, I would go about implementing it this way. So in this case, the onQueue command will be constant time.
Okay.
The DQ command would be constant time as well in the best case scenario. Because we DQ one right now with this D command. Let's say I have D again, I'll just be popping things out. But that one time when this stack is empty, or this stack is empty and I want to DQ, then that will be linear time.
Okay.
So the worst case scenario is still linear time. And the space complexity would be linear as well.
So basically, we have this DQ stack, and if that's empty, that's the only time we empty the onQueue stack.
Yep.
So the next time I encounter an NQ, it will just push into NQ stack, and it doesn't have to do anything with DQ stack.
Yes, exactly. So the next time you encounter, let's say, 7, then you want to onQueue 8. At this point, this is empty.
Yeah.
So then I onQueue 8 there. And if I want, and then let's say there's a DQ again, then I DQ'd 1 and 2, so these two don't exist anymore. And then the top of the stack is 3. So I DQ that. Let's say I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 more of these DQs. So this whole thing goes away. So now if I have another DQ, then I see, oh, this is empty. So I need to reverse this entire onQ stack onto DQ stack again, like we did before.
Okay, I see. So basically, you are implementing this queue using two stacks, right?
Yep.
So can you do it with just one stack?
Just one stack.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's think. Let's think about it. So if I do it with just one stack, let's say this is the stack. So in this case, I won't have that. So if you don't mind, I'll just erase. I'll erase this entire thing. Let's say I'll just keep one stack. It's not an onQ stack anymore. So let's say this is my stack. And I'm onQueuing things. So I will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's say I'm onQueuing the first 6. Now if I want to dequeue something right now, in some way, I will need to reverse this entire thing. So if you say that I'm just implementing it using one stack, is it possible for, well, it wouldn't really make sense for me to have an array or anything else, right? So basically you're saying, oh, the only data structure I have is a stack.
Correct.
Nothing else.
Correct.
Okay. Okay. Actually, we can do it. So the purpose of a DQ stack was just to have the things in memory, the integers in memory, right? And if you're not using a data structure, we can still have them in memory somehow. So I'm not saying have them in memory using an array, because that would be, in a sense, as long as the program is running, like a persistent memory. But if we don't want to use something like that, then we can store it in memory. So basically, I can say, okay, look at 6. Is that the last one? If it's not the last one, then look at 5. Look at 4. Look at 3. Look at 2. And then look at 1. 1 is the last one, so return 1. And that's the answer. And throughout that time, all of these would be in memory. Then it goes back again. It says, okay, we found our answer. Push 2 back in, 3 back in, 4 back in, 5 back in, 6 back in.
Okay, so basically you will be looping through.
I think looping would be one way to do it. The thing I was thinking was just recursing through the stack. So if you don't mind, let me just lay out the operations.
Yeah, sure.
Or we can actually, I think it'll go hand in hand. Let me think about this, how it'll go. And then I'll lay out the operations as well. So let's say these are the ops. If I want to recurse through the stack and go all the way down, the end condition for me would be, so some way I'll need to take into account the length of the stack, right? So one of the properties of the stack would then be length as well. So I'll say let's say this is a function, right? So this is, let's say, function DQ. And let's say this is inside of the scope of a bigger class or a bigger function that already has the stack in it.
Okay.
So it has access to the stack.
So it's a part of Q.
It's part of Q, yes. It's part of the Q class. So in order for me to do this, I will need to recurse. So basically, even before recursing, let's say I define the end condition, which is if stack dot length is 1, if stack dot length is 1, then return stack dot pop. So in this case, if the length is 1, it'll just return this. Right? Now if it's not 1, then you want to store each one of these in memory somehow. So I will say let, well, it's pseudocode, but basically I will say value or curve value, let's say, equals stack.pop for this iteration.
Mm-hmm.
So in essence, I just stored this in memory, right? So I will say, okay, curve value stack.pop. I know that there are more values because this condition didn't meet. Mm-hmm. And I'm still going forward. So I say stack.pop, and then I say dq again. Maybe I could have named this function better, you know? Dq, I'm not like dqing multiple times. So just so we are both clear, mm-hmm. let me just name this recurse. Just so we don't confuse ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
So I say recurse.
Okay.
And once, after I recurse, I want to make sure that, okay, I store this in memory. Now I'm recursing, I'm going all the way down. At the end, I want to push it back to the stack, right? So I'll say stack dot push curve value.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, we won't even go into this recursion if our first check says that the stack is empty, you know? Then we won't, then our Q class won't even call the recurse function.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So basically, assuming that the stack has at least one value and we embark on this series of operations, mm-hmm. then we will have, we will basically, you start with 6, right? You start with 6. I store this in memory, 6. Then, as soon as I store it in memory, I say recurse. So I go into 5. I store that in memory.
Mm-hmm.
4, memory. 3, memory. 2, memory. And then, as soon as it hits 1, now the stack length is 1.
Mm-hmm.
So what it does is it returns 1. Right? So in this case, actually, I need to store this recurse as well. So I'll say let result equals recurse.
Mm-hmm.
And then at the end, obviously, I need to return something. So I'll say return result. So what happens is 1 is returned, right? And then for the second one, the recurse value that is returned is 1, and then it pushes 2 back again. So 2 is now in the bottom of the stack.
Mm-hmm.
And then it returns 3. Then 3 is pushed back again, it's bottom of the stack. It returns 4, so on and so forth. So it's the same stack that we're operating on.
Mm-hmm.
So the final result of the stack will be 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6.
Mm-hmm.
So this would give me the result mimicking a queue using just one stack. And
okay,
obviously,
so I get this function
mm-hmm.
is dequeuing.
Right.
So can you write the entire queue class for me?
Yep. Yeah.
Yeah.
So let me erase this. And let's say this is a function inside of the queue class.
Mm-hmm.
Let's call it queue. And what it has is, let's say it has a stack. Now the implementation mm-hmm. of a stack optimally would be with a linked list.
Mm-hmm.
But just for the sake of this, let's say I have an array that mimics a stack. So inside of this, let's say I have stack equals an array.
Mm-hmm.
Now I have another function that says, let's say this is, this is a recurse function. Let's say I have this dot, so it's basically an instance function, this dot on queue would basically take the value,
mm-hmm.
and what it'll do is it'll just say stack. Stack.push.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say stack.push value. Right?
I see.
Now, on the other hand, when I have this.dequeue, let's say it takes in a, it doesn't take in anything, right? So it's just a command. So in this case, it'll say, okay, I want to dequeue something. Let me make sure that there is something in the stack already. Mm-hmm. So this will, it'll basically have the condition, if stack dot length is not equal to zero, recurse. So it'll basically call return recurse. Mm-hmm. So it would basically return the result like we did. Else basically they're trying to dequeue something that's not even there. So depending on what the business logic is, mm-hmm. maybe we say return error, you know? Else throw exception. Mm-hmm. But basically this would at a high level be the Q class.
Looks good.
Perfect. So let's see what we learned from this interview. Well, sometimes the interviewer may make the problems more complex as you're going through them, and that's okay. Just make sure you ask a lot of clarifying questions and that the problem is clear in your head before you proceed, and then just go ahead and solve it. So I hope you liked this video. If you did, make sure you like it, you subscribe, and also subscribe to my YouTube channel, which I have in the description below, where I post a new Whiteboard Wednesday every week. Take care.